Hi students, today we are going to talk about new topic. This is successful people. Within this topic we'll have some information about employment law, basic words. Our plan for today is a present perfect tense, then we'll discuss some vocabulary related to employment law and how to write a CV. First of all, grammar, present perfect tense. Present perfect tense is usually used to talk about general events and experience in the past, but the time is not specific. That's why it's called unspecified time before now. In the picture, you can see that something happened in the past, and this is between past and present. So, happened in the past, but result in the present. For this such kind of events, we use present perfect tense. Let's talk about the form of present perfect tense. To form present perfect tense, we need auxiliary verb have, but it has two forms, have and has. For the third person singular, we use the form has. And for positive or affirmative form, the structure will be subject plus auxiliary verb have or has plus the verb past participle. For question form, we move auxiliary verb have and has before the subject. Then, for the negative form, we put not after the auxiliary verb have and has. In this example, you can see these kind of forms. First statement, you have seen that movie many times. Question form, have you seen that movie many times? And the negative form will be, you haven't seen that movie many times. Let's have more information about past participle. For this purpose, we selected two kind of verbs. They are regular and irregular. The past participle and simple past forms of the regular verbs is simple because we have to add ed after the stem of the verb. We selected three verbs, finish, stop and wait. Let's see how they will change their form in past simple. Finished, stopped, and waited. Past participle form will be the same. Finished, stopped, waited. Irregular verbs. We selected see, make, and put. Simple past form and past participle forms of this kind of verb will be different because the stem of the verb will change when we transfer them into past, simple, or past participle forms. Let's see past simple forms. See become saw, make become made, put doesn't have any change, put and put. Now past participle form. Seen, made and put. Let's have more practice. Here is mixed forms of irregular and regular verb. First is stopped. Past participle will be, yes, the same, stopped. Next verb is go, past simple is went, and past participle is, yes, gone. Next, take, took, taken, write, wrote, written. So, next form is contraction or shortened forms of this verb. You can see the sentence, I've gone home, you've gone home. Safe and we've gone home, but the third person singular has another kind of form. After pronoun, we just she's, he's gone home. It's been hot all week. Now, here you can see extract from a text. It's about very famous and successful musician who was awarded with Grammy Award. In this text, you can see five blanks and verbs in a bracket. Let's make practice. Number one, Joni Mitchell. She made, yes, she has made 21 albums. Next, say, musician has have said. Number three, John Mitchell. Right. Yes, has written. Others are the same. Next. Now, time for short answers. Have you read all of this article? No, I haven't. I have only read a few pages. Short answer, have or haven't. Next, third person singular. Has Kyung finished her homework? Yes, she has. She did it after school. Now, second part is dedicated to the employment law. Employment, in the picture you can see office. It may be any kind of organization where people work. So it regulates rights of workers, their work. And now let's see basic vocabulary related to this employment law. Number one, employer and employee. In the picture you can see one man and many people behind him. This man who provides work to his workers is called employer. So his workers who work for him are employee or employees. Next, secretary and admin work. Secretary is a position in an office. Usually his or her job is to answer the calls, organizing meetings, doing some paperwork. Next, admin work. So admin work, it's a work that is done by administration of the organization. Usually they are doing some paperwork or calculation on computer. Next, very important word, wage and salary. Both of them mean payment, but the duration is different. Workers who worked for a week and receiving their payment, this amount of money is called wage. It means your payment for a week. Next one, salary is monthly payment. Each month employees receive salary. Next word, full-time and part-time. People who work from morning till the evening, the whole day, usually it starts at 9 o'clock and ends at 5 or 6 o'clock, are working full-time. Part-time job, people may work from morning till afternoon, or from afternoon till the evening. They may work not only one place but in several workplaces. So they work part-time. Next, track record. Track record is experience of a person who worked in one sphere. It's very important when you apply for a new job. They usually ask for your track record. Next, it's payroll. It's usually a type of document where name of people or employees are written, and how much time, how many hours they worked is also shown in this document. According to this document, they can receive their salary or wage. Now, the last part is dedicated to writing CV. What is CV? CV is detailed information about a person. Usually, when person applies for a job, they ask it to bring this kind of document. In the picture, you can see one example of CV. Usually, at the beginning, it's asked to include information like name and contact information. In our example, name is already written, James Smith. You can just change into your name. Then about contact information, you can include your telephone number or email. Next, summary or objective. In this part of CV, you have to write why are you applying for this job? What are you going to do in this job? What kind of profit, benefit you can bring to your workplace? It's very important part of the CV. Next, work experience. Work experience, here you have to write where did you work before applying a new job, name of organization, your position, usually it's called job title, period of time that you worked, and if you you have to describe your role in this organization. Next one is education. Here you will include information about where did you study, bachelor degree, master degree. Part like work experience and education should be in chronological order. Next, skills. Here you can write what kind of languages, how many languages do you know, or do you have IT skills or another skill that is can be used in your work. Next one, it's written optional. If you have any kind of a word, it's humans, you can include it in this part. Maybe you have some certificates from your working place or IELTS certificate from language, you can show your band score in this part. From today's lesson, if you include and learn all these words, it will lead you to success. Thank you.